Hi, let's go ahead and talk about InDesign chapter in a book, chapter 13, which is all about printing and exporting. What I want you mainly to get out of this chapter is how to fix errors in documents and how to package a document. So let's go ahead and go to our flash drive first. In our flash drive, I want you to go ahead and make a new folder. So you can right click, new and folder. And I'm going to do InDesign classroom in a book. So I have a place to store all of my documents. It's really important to be an organized designer because it'll make your life a whole lot easier than having one file on this top desktop and that one on another, and you'll end up with a lot of errors and a lot of stress trying to find those documents and images again. All right, let's go ahead and go back into Canvas, grab that zip file. I'm going to go ahead and tell it to go to my flash drive, which is my USB, my InDesign Classroom and Book folder. I'm going to push save, and it's going to go ahead and download for me. It's going to take a little bit. Some of these files are kind of big. Now, it's downloading a zipped file. A zipped file means it is bringing all the images and everything, all the fonts, all the different copies of the InDesign documents into one single folder. That makes life a whole lot easier because it allows you to do a single download instead of having to do multiple one piece at a time downloads. So now I can see it has been downloaded. It has a little zipper on the folder. I'm going to go ahead and I need to extract it. So when I click on it, I can either go to my compressed, extract tools, and do extract all, or I can do right click and do extract all as well. It's going to say, where do you want to save it? I want to go ahead and put it on my flash drive, which is L, my InDesign Classroom and Book folder, and in make a subfolder called this, which is unzipped, I say extract. Now it says show extracted fields when you're done, which means show me the folder when you've got it all finished. This is going to take just a little bit, but it's not too big of a deal, just to wait and get it done. Alright, so in the meantime, if you have not already, make sure you've got InDesign booted up, because that will make our life a lot easier here in a minute or so. Alright, so it is nearly extracted. There's my InDesign popping up. I'm not worried about that right now. I'm going to minimize it. All right, so now I have, if I go to my classroom in a book, I now have my zipped folder and I have an unzipped folder. The unzipped folder is the one I want to be working out of. If you try and work out of the zipped folder, you won't be able to see anything and it's going to give you a major headache. All right, let's go ahead and double click InDesign Classroom Book Lesson 13. In here, you'll see I've got one called Document Fonts, I've got links, and I've got three different documents. One says start, one says end, and one says 16 pagers. The start is where you will start as part as the assignment. The end is given to you so that you know what it is supposed to look like when you are finished. What you're going to do is follow along with the book, chapter 13, and I'll walk you through some of the highlights of that here. And then after you finish this, go through and go step by step through all the different elements. Make sure you look at Canvas for the sections that you can skip. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and hit start, and it's going to go ahead and open up all of my documents. Now you're going to get this problem here. It says you have a missing link and you have modified links. Normally I would tell you yes, hit update links, because it's going to go ahead and connect, I call it connect the dots between the InDesign document and the folder where you have all those images saved. For our purposes, because I want to show you how to break it, I'm going to say don't update links. Alright, so now I've got my document that came in. You'll notice it's really fuzzy and looks kind of gross. That can be fixed by going up to Window, or View, Display Performance, High Quality Display. Because we want to run InDesign as quickly as possible, it will give us a copy of the images that is not the best quality. You see it's kind of all pixelated and weird right now. It will clean up once we get the display quality, high quality turned on. So let's go ahead and fix a few things. We've got our flora and fauna, we've got different text boxes here, and we've got this one, which is all pixelated and gross looking, and it's got a question mark, which means that it is a missing link. So if you click, if you point at the queue, it will usually tell you what's going on. So it's telling you that this is missing. It doesn't know where to find this problem. So we go over here to our palette over here, and go to the chains. The chains is links. If you don't see that, you can always go to window and open links there as well. And Adobe is famous for giving you 15 ways to do one thing. So I'm going to go ahead and click here. And when I click here, it says, okay, where is it? So I'm going to go ahead and look in my classroom in a book. Look in the folder, and I'm going to look in this one called links. In the one called links, I should have one that says tagline. But we've changed the color of the tagline. Now it's periwinkle, which is a blue. So I'm going to take that and say open. And what it's going to do is replace that image. And see, now it's not pixelated, it's not weird looking. And it's telling us with this little chain link right here that it has been linked. InDesign does not place your actual images in the document. InDesign keeps them in a separate folder and gives you a placeholder in order to keep the file size smaller. All right, so now we have all these other problems. If you notice right here, it says I've got 21 errors. That's a lot of errors. You want zero errors. It says red light problem. So if you click on the down arrow, you get what's called the pre-flight menu, pre-flight panel, which is going to show you what the different problems are. If you click the arrow, it will expand and tell you what are all the different problems you've got. So right now it says I have a problem with river landscape, and I have a problem with sea oats, which is on page 4. If I click on sea oats page 4, it will automatically go to that image and give me boxes around the image, the problem that we're having. So I can go ahead and go to the exclamation point and say relink it. Or I can go over here, so I've got B on a flower, and go down here to my chain links and say I want to relink. So I want B on a flower, so I go into my links folder and I find B on a flower and say reconnect. And now it's fixed that error. So what you can do is go through, and if you double click, because it knows where these are, it will fix all of those errors for us. This is where if you'd put update links at the beginning, you would not get all these problems. Your problem is when you save the image somewhere different than your links or your images folder. It doesn't know where to find it. So now it's still telling me I have 6 errors. What are my 6 errors? So if I use my panel over here, my palette, I still see, oh, I've got a few more that did not get updated. So normally, no, you would not have to go through this process if you push update links, but I do want you to see what happens when you break them. So now it's happy. We say no errors, which is awesome. And we can go ahead and close the pre-flight panel. Now in the book, I want you to go ahead and skip several sections. Go ahead and look at Canvas for which ones you don't have to do. I do want you to look at creating an Adobe PDF, because not everyone has InDesign, which means it makes it a lot harder for them to look at your documents. Let's go ahead and make a PDF so you can share this with Grandma. So let's go to File and go to Export. In Export, it's going to say, okay, where do you want me to save? We're going to say, keep the name the same, and go ahead and put it in the same folder. We want it to be a PDF. We've got all these other options. We want a PDF for print. We don't need interactive because this is not something with links, it's not something with videos that we need to be able to play. And push save. Here's going to pop up this dialog box. We want it to say high quality print. We want it to export as pages, not as spreads. Think of spreads as when you have a magazine or a book open and you can see 2 pages at once. It would actually create a PDF that has 2 pages on it at one time, which is awesome if you're trying to save paper when you're printing, but for the most part you don't want to print spreads. We want view PDF after exporting, which means after you are done making the PDF, show it to me so I can make sure everything's okay. Here we have compression. We have a lot of options as to what kind of quality does this PDF have. This affects your file size in the end. If you're taking it to print, you want to have that high quality print selected. There's several other presets, smallest file size, so maybe you're trying to upload it to a website, you're doing some other things, you don't care about the image quality as much. There's a lot of different ways to shrink your file size. For what we're doing, high quality print is fine. We can go to marks and bleeds. Here's where you can say whether or not you want to have what's called the printer's marks. I'm going to go ahead and tell it to do crop marks and registration marks just so you can see what those different things do. I'll do all of them. Output, we're not worried too much about that. You can, if you're worried about size or worried about people with older computers trying to open this, you can back it up so it can do an older version of Acrobat. We're not worried about that. So I'm going to say export. It's going to go through, and since we said to look at it afterward, we will be able to see the PDF. You can tell it's thinking right now. And here we are. Now, because I told it to turn all those printer's marks on, that's why I have all this extra information. So these in the corner are called the crop marks. That is where the printer would actually cut the document, usually print it a little bit bigger in order to get that full bleed, in order to print from side to side. Here's what you call the color bars. The color bars allow the printer to make sure that the colors are coming in true and that everything's matching the way it should be. You also can get the footers down here, which tells us the name of the document, the page, the date, and when it was printed or when it was created. This helps especially with versions if you've got multiple versions going on. Let's go ahead and close that up. All right, so the last step, you've created your document, it's beautiful, you're ready to go, you have no errors. We need to package. So we go to File and Package. We click Package. This is going to give us a summary. It's going to say we want to do the entire publication. It's going to tell us how many fonts we have. It's going to tell us about our links and images. It's going to tell us what type of colors we've got going on. It's going to tell us a lot of different information. You might also get one here that will say don't steal the fonts. I think mine's turned off, but if you do get one, it's okay. Yes, we want to save it before we continue. It's going to pop up a dialog box, which is instructions. Instructions are for the printer, so when you hand this off, you can say, if you have problems, go ahead and call me at my address and my phone number. And this file gets automatically put in the file. Think of it as sticking a post-it note on your file for the printer. So we're going to say continue. All right, I'm going to go to my package, my InDesign file. I'm going to say this is InDesign, Classroom in a Book, 13, maybe, and Package, because that way I will know which one to turn in. A lot of times people will find that they can't remember which ones they worked on. So if you rename the folder before you start, it'll make your life a lot easier. We do want it to copy fonts. We do want it to copy links, which means go and find all the fonts, all the images, and put them in this folder with us. We do want it to be able to update them. We do want IDML, which means put in a previous version of InDesign in case someone can't open it with the version that I'm using. We do want to create the PDF. We do want it to be a high quality PDF. And we're going to go ahead and tell it to package. Now this can take a little bit of time. It depends on how many images you have, how many fonts, how big your document is. So always give yourself time to package before trying to submit. I've had students in the past who have waited till 11:58 to try and package and had late assignments because they did not give themselves enough time. So it's saving a copy, it's putting the fonts in, it's putting itself together, saving the document. So I'm going to go ahead and go to my File Explorer and look in that file that I've created. So I've got this one now called InDesign Classroom Book 13 Packaged. In that file, I can see that I've got all the fonts, I've got all the links, which is all the images, I've got my InDesign document, and my IDML, which is the if you have previous versions, and it made a PDF, and here's my instructions. So it says, here's the information, here's anything else you need to know. So, you can't turn this one in. You've got to go ahead and do one more step, which is to package it and zip it. So I'm going to go ahead and right-click, and I'm going to do Send to Compressed or Zipped Folder. Then it's going to create a zipped folder. On a Mac, it's Send to Compress File. So you will get a zipped file. What you're going to submit is that zipped file in the end. And it takes a little bit, depending on how much stuff is in there. So now I've got this InDesign package.zip. So I would go to Canvas, And on my student version, I would go to Submit Assignment, which would be right up here. I would explore to my file, go grab that zip, and upload that zip file. And that's what you need to know for Chapter 13. Go ahead and do the step-by-steps. And don't forget, you can skip parts of it as according to Canvas. Thanks.